This is MJ with MinIO. Welcome back to the Kubernetes overview portion of the MinIO on Kubernetes and MinIO Operator course. Let's jump into the next topic.
So next we're going to talk about pods. And pods are the basic building block of Kubernetes. Pods provide encapsulation of application containers, or in some cases multiple containers inside a pod. So it doesn't just have to be one container. There could be a primary container, there could be an init container, other containers that support what's running inside of that pod. They also provide encapsulation of storage resources within that specific pod, and it gives all of the containers within that pod a unique network IP inside the Kubernetes cluster. It also provides options that govern how the container should run, so basic configurations for what these containers should be doing. You can think of the pods as a wrapper around a container or multiple containers that provides additional functionality inside the cluster. And for MinIO, the pods are the containers that run the MinIO server and also the MinIO tenants. So basically, every time you spin up a deployment for MinIO inside Kubernetes, there will be specific pods associated with that deployment. So let's do a quick pod demo within our cluster. So the first thing we're going to do is deploy a pod using the command line. Now, just for reference, I'm simply showing you this so you can understand how pods work. I do not recommend that you deploy pods as what I call singletons, but rather that you use deployments to manage your pods, which we will talk about deployments next, but I just want to show you this concept. So from the command line, you could actually run something like kubectl run the name of the pod that you want to give it, and then the image that you want to pull down. In this case, we're going to use nginx, and which namespace you actually want to deploy this to. In our case, we're going to deploy this to the MinIO namespace. So if I do this, it says the pod was created. And if I do kubectl get pods, you're going to see an error message that says no resources are found in the default namespace. So if you do not specify a namespace, or you have not switched your context within Kubernetes, again, this is where knowledge of Kubernetes and how it works is going to be important, then you will not see the pod that you expect. You actually have to specify the namespace that you want to look in. So if I say minus n for namespace MinIO, now we can see that this nginx CLI pod is running inside that namespace. You can also deploy pods as YAML, just as we did with the namespaces previously. So as you can see here, if I look at our pod YAML, you can see here that this is going to deploy a pod with the name nginx into the namespace MinIO, and it's going to pull the container image of nginx. So if we do a k apply minus f pod, you can see that that's created. And if we run our command inside the MinIO namespace again, you can see that there are now two pods running inside this namespace. One is for the one that we ran from the CLI, and the other one was created by the YAML that we just showed.
Thanks for joining us for this Kubernetes overview topic as part of the MinIO on Kubernetes and MinIO Operator course. We look forward to seeing you in the next video. Thanks and have a good one.